Psoriatic arthritis is an inflammatory arthritis that is autoimmune and can cause pain, stiffness, and inflammation in the joints. And it often happens in patients with known psoriasis, but it may actually also happen in people without the skin manifestations. So sometimes the arthritis in psoriatic arthritis actually happens first. It's an autoimmune condition, which means that the immune system is mistaking the joints, in this case, as a target. So the immune system is sending signals to cause pain, swelling, and inflammation in the joints, which is why a lot of our treatments for psoriatic arthritis are very similar to our treatments for rheumatoid arthritis and are actually immunomodulators. The diagnosis of psoriatic arthritis can be challenging. When it's simple, it's when a patient who already has known psoriasis develops the typical symptoms of an inflammatory arthritis, such as swelling, morning stiffness, and discomfort in the joint when there's been no trauma or some mechanical reason why they would have those symptoms. Sometimes the inflammation levels in the blood tests will be high. And sometimes the x-rays will also show signs of psoriatic arthritis. The times when the diagnosis can be challenging is when the patient actually doesn't have psoriasis and their blood tests are negative, which can happen because psoriatic arthritis is one of the types of inflammatory arthritis that we say or term as seronegative, meaning we don't have a specific diagnostic marker in the blood that we can test for. There's been, I think I would term it, an explosion of great advancements in the treatment of psoriatic arthritis, partly stemming from all the research and advances in rheumatoid arthritis. There's a lot of overlap in the treatment, but also in specific treatments for psoriatic arthritis, which is also contributed to by the advances for the treatment of psoriasis. So we have a lot more treatment options these days for psoriatic arthritis.